Welcome, Lord Lovers, to another tale from the rich tapestry of League of Legends universe. Today we delve into the harrowing saga of Sion, a figure shrouded in the shadows of a brutal past. Once hailed as a fearsome warlord of a forgotten era, Sion's legend was etched in the annals of Noxian history. His hands, once stained with the lifeblood of a Demacian king, became the staff of nightmares, a symbol of raw power and unyielding brutality. But death could not claim him, for fate had darker plans. Resurrected from the abyss, Sion found himself bound to serve his empire once more. Yet in this accursed existence, he was but a hollow shell of his former self, stripped of all humanity. Clad in armor cobbled together from crude scraps, Sion rampages across the battlefield, leaving naught but devastation in his wake. His axe cleaves through friend and foe alike, a relentless force of chaos and destruction. As we witness his relentless charge into the fray, one cannot help but wonder, does the echo of his true self still linger amidst the carnage, or is Sion condemned to be forever lost in the maelstrom of his own savagery? Join me as we uncover the twisted tale of Sion, the relentless juggernaut of Noxus. In a distant era, Sion, the ruthless warlord, ascended to prominence through a path paved with the blood of those who dared oppose him. Revered and dreaded in equal measure, he stood at the last embodiment of a proud warrior tradition woven into the fabric of Noxian history since its inception. Bound by solemn oaths to his forebears, Sion pledged to never retreat in battle and to meet his end with the dignity of a true warrior. Despite lacking finesse or strategic brilliance, Sion's brutal tactics proved devastatingly effective, securing numerous triumphs for the mighty Empire of Noxus. However, the sudden resistance from a western nation caught the Noxian High Command off guard, as Demacian forces halted and even pushed back their relentless advance. Forced to redirect his campaign from the Argent Mountains to the south, Sion's fury burned bright upon encountering the Demacian host on the horizon. Though the enemy showed no intention of besieging Vardis, having already driven the Noxians from neighboring lands, Sion stood resolute in his determination to punish their defiance. Yet, to his dismay, the Noxian commander at Vardis, having suffered repeated defeats, chose to cower behind the safety of the city walls rather than confront the foe. Outraged by this display of cowardice and betrayal of their shared sacrifice, Sion cast aside the commander and ordered the attack without hesitation. With unwavering resolve, Sion led his warriors in a ferocious assault, relentlessly cutting through the Demacian ranks in pursuit of their leader, King Jarvan I. Despite the fearless charge of his own warband, the cowardice of those within Vardis led to their eventual retreat, leaving Sion and his loyal few surrounded. Undeterred by the onslaught of enemy blades and bolts that pierced his flesh, Sion pressed on, driven by an unyielding determination to confront Jarvan. In a savage duel, the Demacian monarch ultimately struck the fatal blow, yet Sion's iron grip remained unbroken as he seized the king's crown, a final testament to his unwavering defiance in the face of death. Only upon the demise of the enemy king did Sion relinquish his grasp on life. His lifeless form, clenching the Demacian crown tightly, was recovered and reverently transported back to the immortal bastion. Noxus grieved the loss of Sion, honoring him with a grand monument that stood as a testament to his indomitable spirit for generations to come. Decades passed before the doors of Sion's tomb were pried open once more. In an era where Noxian supremacy faltered, Grand General Boron Darkwill, desperate to revive the Empire's former glory, seized upon a sinister opportunity. Through the machinations of the enigmatic Black Rose, Sion was resurrected using forbidden sorceries and presented the tool to Darkwill. Bound by forces beyond mortal comprehension, Sion returned to the realm of the living, consumed by an insatiable thirst for bloodshed and impervious to pain. Unleashed upon the battlefield once again, Sion became an unstoppable force, leaving devastation in his wake. Yet, unlike before, his victories came at a staggering cost, as his unchecked rampage spared neither friend nor foe. Desertion plagued those forced to fight alongside him, prompting Darkwill to order Sion's re-interment. Countless lives were sacrificed in the effort to contain him, until finally he was subdued and imprisoned within the Immortal Bastion. Ensnared by chains and ensconced beneath his towering statue, Sion languished in a limbo of fury, neither truly living nor dead. With the fall of Darkwill and the rise of Jericho Swain, Sion's tomb was reopened to a changed empire. Unfazed by the shifting tides of power, Sion yearned only for the chaos of battle, his mind consumed by an insatiable thirst for destruction. Unleashed upon the rebellious city of Vardis, now under Sion's rule, Sion wrought havoc upon his defenders, relishing in the chaos and devastation he wrought. The mere threat of his unleashed fury compelled other regions to submit to Noxian authority, lest they face the wrath of the undead juggernaut. As the light of day pierces his prison once more, Sion embraces the opportunity for carnage, driven by fragmented memories of his past and an unyielding hunger for conquest. In his relentless pursuit of bloodshed, the world once again trembles before the unstoppable force that is Sion. The Story in the Mind of Madness presents the relentless juggernaut of Noxus as he roams the desolate corridors of his mind, consumed by an insatiable hunger for one thing, blood. In the depths of his consciousness, primal urges surge like a torrential storm, urging him to unleash his fury upon any who dare cross his path. His senses are alight with the scent of blood, a tantalizing aroma that stirs the depth of his being, igniting a burning desire that cannot be quenched. With every heartbeat, the anticipation of battle courses through his veins, driving him ever closer to the precipice of madness. Yet, amidst the chaos of his thoughts, fragments of memories flicker like distant stars in the night sky, reminders of a past drenched in conquest and glory. But as the echoes of victory fade, a chilling realization descends upon him like a shroud of darkness. Bound within the confines of his own mind, Sion grapples with the weight of captivity, his once indomitable spirit shackled by unseen chains. In the shadows of his subconscious, whispers of treachery and betrayal echo, taunting him with visions of impending doom. Yet, amidst the turmoil, a flicker of defiance glimmers like a beacon in the darkness, a reminder that even in captivity, the spirit of a warrior cannot be extinguished. And so, as the clamor of battle fades into silence, Sion's primal instincts remain ever vigilant, a testament to the undying will of a true Noxian warrior. Blood, the eternal chorus that echoes through the halls of his mind, a reminder of the insatiable hunger that drives him ever forward, toward an uncertain fate. Sion's relations in life and beyond the grave are complex and deeply intertwined with the political machinations of Noxus. As the Hand of Noxus in his previous life, Sion was a formidable figure within the Empire, revered for his strength and feared for his brutality. However, his resurrection at the hands of Black Rose, likely orchestrated by the enigmatic LeBlanc, with Vladimir playing a significant role, thrust him back into the world as a pawn in the power struggles of Noxus. Upon Swain's ascent to power, overthrowing Baron Darkwing and assuming the mantle of Grand General, he recognized the potential of Sion as a powerful asset in his own schemes. Swain sought to harness Sion's unstoppable might for his own purposes, utilizing him as a weapon in the second Noxian invasion of Ionia. In this conflict, Sion clashed with the resistance forces led by Irelia, with support from formidable allies such as Karma, Akali, Kenan, and Yasuo. Sion's role as a tool of Noxian aggression further solidified his ties to the shifting alliances and power struggles within the Empire, marking him as a symbol of both strength and manipulation in the tumultuous landscape of Noxian politics. As we conclude our journey through the tangled web of Sion's story, lore lovers, remember to delve deeper into the lore of League of Legends universe by exploring the intricate relationships and power dynamics that shape its characters and events. If you've enjoyed this exploration into Sion's past and present, don't forget to leave a like, share this video with fellow lore enthusiasts, and subscribe to Liondrag for more captivating tales from the realms of Runeterra. For those craving even more lore-rich discussions and insights, consider joining our Discord server, where you can engage in deeper conversation with like-minded individuals about the mysteries and intricacies of the League of Legends universe. Thank you for joining me on this journey, lore lovers. Until next time, may your curiosity guide you through the depths of Runeterra's lore.